and because tomorrow we are going to submit your marks for the semester one, and I think at around 27 or 28 you will get the result. It depends. Let's see when we will get the result. But means after 4 or 5 days you will get the result. So I'll present my screen for the syllabus. I hope my screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
So, this is the second semester related to Internet of Things syllabus. And in this, actually, you should have the basic knowledge of the networking. So, I hope you all are having the basic knowledge of networking because already you have done in the degree, and you had in the first semester this networking subject.
No, ma'am.
So basically, Internet of Things, this is a fully theoretical subject in this, and no problems, no sums and all, but we have the most of the things we are having the architecture, different architectures which we will learn in this Internet of Things. So basically this Internet of Things are having the networking frontier. So this networking frontier, how the Internet of Things have been invented, what is the reason behind that, that we will cover in the Internet of Things overview, this overview. Okay. So the background and different IoT definitions, how it is going to monitor and control the things, and how it is going to connect it with the internet, and who will monitor and control, what is the securities, and IoT reference frameworks, and different types of factors which are going to be affected into the Internet of Things, which is connected to the particular, which is designed for the particular aim. Right. Then this next chapter we have the internet in IoT. So basically, this is the whatever the devices are going to be designed, that is based on the, that will work on the internet only, which give the real time data. So basically there are different types of results are there on that base on the particular object, and there are different wide varieties of end devices which will be connected to the Internet of Things. So that will give the real time data, like a tap or washer or fridge or washing machine. So these are the devices are based on the different types of sensors. So how the sensors are being used, right? And in this internet, when we are going to connect the that device into the with the internet, so what are the protocols which we will use, what are the layers, right? So these are the different layers which we will do in the second chapter. Then the third chapter is having the things in IoT, that is the sensors and actuators. So in this we will learn about the different types of sensors and actuators which will work on the device, and based on that sensor or actuators we will get the real-time data and how it is going to be programmed. So IoT sensors, RFID, and main uses of RFID applications, video tracking, video tracking applications, IoT actuators, and actuator types. So these are the theoretical things which we will do in the in this sensors and actuators. Next, we have the IoT protocol stack and a layered views. So in this section, different protocols. Why we cannot use the simple protocols, and why we are having in the IoT devices, why we have the different types of protocols like the TCP, IP, and why we cannot use IP for the IoT only. Okay. So with these are the different things which we will learn. And there are different types of engineers or which are widely available in the protocol stacks, or different types of devices which is used are PCs and smartphones, and based on the which is connected to the PCs and smartphones, so that we will do the programming, and we can activate the sensors or actuators so that we can implement and get the data. So these are the things which we will do in this chapter. Then IoT services platforms, functions and requirements. So this IoT services platforms means when we are going to design a new type of IoT device, or when we are using the sensors and actuators. So what are the platforms are available, whether it is a cross platform or a standalone platform we can use, and which platform is comfortable for the IoT devices. Okay, what are the data management, what are the repository for the IoTs, and element manager, configuration management, fault management, performance management. So different managements and functions we will do in this chapter. And Internet of Things, security and privacy. So in this we will learn the security, whatever the data we are using, we are collecting from the IoT devices, whether it is secure, and if it is not secure, how we can make it secure, and what are the architecture we can use for the security and for the privacy of the data. And you can see here in the syllabus IoT security challenges, IoT security requirements, IoT 3 domain architecture, cloud domain attacks, and countermeasures for domain attack, and countermeasures, sensing domain attacks, and countermeasures, summary and future directions. In IoT vertical market and connected ecosystem. So in this there are where we can implement actually IoT devices, what is the use of IoT devices in the market, and where we can use, like you can see IoT verticals, IoT agriculture and farming for moisture and for manure. Okay, so these are the devices will work on the sensors only. So these are the sensors are already available in the market, and it hardly cost 250, 300 around. It depends. Okay, so that using these sensors, you will get come to know what are the pros and cons of that. Of that device, or where we can use, how, when, so it basically it is automation, so that that a human being should not be present there. And IoT energy solution, IoT oil and gas solution, IoT smart building solution, IoT finance. So these are the devices which we can implement into the system, and automatically it will work. And IoT in healthcare, IoT industrial, IoT retail, IoT transportation, so, IoT service model, anything as a services. So what other services are going to be provided by these devices? And different types of terminologies, and we'll see here. And this is the last chapter, role of open source in IoT. So there are different types of programming which we have to do on the device in the C or C++ or Python, whatever the language you are working with. So drivers for open source consumers, drivers for open source contributors, open source versus standards. So this is the small syllabus, actually not that much good, that would be the boss, but fully theoretical part we have to do in the theory. And for covering the syllabus, you can refer this textbook, first one. It's the best book for covering this one. You can refer all the books are very nice, very good, but this book is basically published in the Springer, and this book covering the whole syllabus as well. But if you want to explore yourself, you can refer these books as well. Now in this lecture 2, we have a lab session as well. So this is a Internet of Things lab. In this, you should have the good knowledge of C, C++, Python. So it's up to you which language you want to use for the programming. And in this Internet of Things labs, I have not decided yet what to do, because it is still virtual mode. And you need a kit, means Raspberry Pi or Arduino. So that I will let you know how you can perform. One thing we can do theoretically, you have to write and you have to search, you have to do R&D based on the theory, and you need to write and submit. One thing this. And the second thing, what we can do, we can make the group of 5 or 6 students, okay? And any one student, you can contribute, or you can purchase the kit, right? Or you can make a one project, or you can perform individually, right? So if you have one option, I will ask you afterwards when we will start the lab session. That means whether you can perform these practical, or if you want to do the simple IoT project. So I don't want to that you can use a big project like you can means if you have a one group, 5 to 6 students are there in the one group, so you can use first like a environmental based sensors, you can use actuators, you can use or soil based or something new you can search. So that I will ask you afterwards, and you all also can discuss to each other what you can do, what will be more comfortable for you, because it is virtual mode. I cannot force you. We cannot stick with the one thing, right? Because whether I don't know when the college will resume, or when we will start the physical education, classes, when we will start, right? So right. So you all will let me know, okay? And actually there are 10 practicals, so at least 8 practicals we have to perform, or else you can do the one project, small project. which we have done in the MC project. And in the MC project, we have some instruments really they have done very nicely in the MC project, and they have recorded it very properly. So that the user, suppose I want to know, so I will come to know ke, what is the procedure is going on in your project. So like that only. So actually what happened, if you are doing the project, see, if you are doing the individually these things, you need different types of sensors, so which is quite difficult for you students to purchase each and every sensors. Like you can see here, first practical is the map familiarization with the Arduino and Raspberry Pi. Okay, so whatever the kits you are using, you should be familiar with that. That means you need to submit the one means you need to know all the parts of the kit, whatever the kit you are using, the first practical. Then second practical, write a program to interface LED buzzer, LED or buzzer with Arduino or Raspberry Pi, and write a program to turn on LED for 1 second after every 2 seconds. So this is the thing. So this is for this practical, you need to purchase the LED and buzzer. Yeah. But then again, we are going to come to the third practical. So write a program to interface push button or digital sensor, IR or LDR. So with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, and write a program. So in for this practical, you need to purchase the push button. I think there is a kit. I put up kit of this Arduino or Raspberry Pi. It costs around 3,000 or 3,500. Online it is available, but I don't think that it will work or not. Okay, so then fourth practical, write a program to interface DHT11 sensor and Arduino Raspberry Pi, and write a program to print temperature and humidity reading. For this, you need to purchase this sensor, temperature and humidity reading, right? Or write a program to interface OLED with Arduino Raspberry Pi, and write a program to print temperature and humidity. So anyhow, you need to purchase this one, right? Then next practical, write a program to interface motor using relay and Arduino or Raspberry Pi, and write a program to turn on motor when push button is pressed. So in this, you need push button. So I think if this push button will be there in the kit, then we are going to purchase the whole kit. 3,500 spending in the brain is different kits. It's quite difficult for every students. Then sixth practical, write a program to interface Bluetooth with Arduino or Raspberry Pi, and write a program to send sensor data to smartphone using the Bluetooth. So for this, we don't need anything, but we should have a smartphone. In that smartphone, we can transfer the data, real-time data. Write a program on Arduino or Raspberry Pi to upload temperature and humidity data to ThinkSpeak Cloud. Here we need to upload the data in the cloud. Write a program to experiment to install MySQL data based on Raspberry Pi and perform basic SQL queries. That means we have the collection of data. So there we can perform the queries. According to the queries, we will get the result. Write a program on Arduino or Raspberry Pi to publish temperature data to MQTT broker and subscribe to MQTT. MQTT worker for temperature data and print kit. And this one, the last one, to say here. It's a theoretical, not practically we can be able to perform, just theoretically you need to write. And you should know the theoretical part of this. And the last one is write a program to create TCP or UDP server on Arduino Raspberry Pi and respond with the humidity data to TCP UDP client when requested. So based on this, suppose I want to know what is the base temperature of Navi mobile. So I'm requesting, and then the server will give the response. So here we will make the connection between the client and server. So these are the things are there. So it's up to you whether you want to perform all this practical or if simply you want to do the one project where you can concentrate on one thing only. Right? Okay. So you all will let me know what you want to do in the practical. Theoretically, theory part we will finish on time, but practically, whatever you want to perform, you just let me know. So, Vaishnav, you can take the initiative for this for IIT practical, or Akash, you can initiative both. You can initiative and you can ask to other or rest of the students, those who are there after IIT. Then accordingly, we will decide what we are supposed to do. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, to purchase the kit, I don't think it will be possible for every student because the kit itself costs around 4,000.
Yes. That's why I was thinking. So, what we can do? You all also think on it. What we can do?
Okay, ma'am. We all will discuss about alternatives which are free and easily available, and then we'll let you know.
Yes. Because nowadays we are too much busy for result, so I am not thinking about the IoT right now. So afterwards I will let you know when the result will be declared. Then afterwards we will be free for this semester subjects. So by that time you all can discuss to each other what are the alternatives. Okay.
Also, ma'am, I don't think so. We can also do it in group because in this period we are not able to meet also with two different people. So the kit would be with only one person.
Yeah. So is it possible to arrange the meeting with whatever the groups you are forming? That group can be present in the meeting, and they only one person can do, another can see, or they can. Give the input for that project.
I think so. It won't be that much beneficial. Only one person would be knowing what is happening in this case.
Okay.
Because I don't think so. It would be like group project. It would be like a single project only.
So what you can do? You all can suggest.
We will think about it and let you.
Yes. In the next lecture, you just let me know what we can do.
Hello, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Ma'am, we can try out the Azure Microsoft IoT Hub. Even I don't know much about
Azure.
It.
But Azure.
Yeah.
Azure.
Yeah. From what I have heard, that it's a simulator for Raspberry Pi. It has a simulator for a Raspberry Pi, and it also has a coding terminal. So of course we need to look into it a bit more, but if it is possible, we can try it out.
Is it freely available? A simulator.
I think it doesn't tell anything about the pricing here. But even if it is, it's not free. I don't think it would cost. More than 3,000, like it would be more costlier than the kit. So if it is cheaper than the kit, then we can surely think about it.
I was also thinking about we can perform the if there are some simulator based on that simulator, we can perform the practicals. But I don't think so. We can do. We all discuss, and I will also discuss with the seniors. If there will be some way, we will find, we will go accordingly.
Okay.
Or in case that last week which option nahi bhi mila, so then lastly we will do theoretically as. What about the other subject? Do you have projects? How many projects do you have in this semester?
Ma'am, we have not been told about that.
So in the mini project, you have any or mini project?
Yes, we have mini project, but the lectures of mini project has not been conducted yet till now.
Okay. Who is taking mini project in this semester?
Kaustubh sir.
And in the last semester?
In the last semester, Nikhil sir was there.
So anything else do you want to ask me? If you have any doubt about the IoT, because still some students are joining, right? The classroom. I don't think so. In this week, all the subject will start properly. From the next week, all the subject will be in a flow. Okay, students. So I don't think so. You have any doubt or?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, the simulator seems free for about 500 devices. Beyond 500 devices, they are charging. Some price for it, and at least I think for our use case it seems free.
Okay, so do you have link?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just mail us WhatsApp me that link, or you can send it here as well.
Okay, ma'am. I'll send it.
Yeah, so I will see what we can do in that simulator. If possible, we will perform here only. And WhatsApp me as well. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
For today, that is enough. And Shalom, bye, and all the best for your result.